In this series, I want to talk about a new old technology that can help us deal with unexpected complexity in our user interfaces. I'm talking about state machines, or more specifically, state charts. State machines have been around since the 1950s. State chart concept, an extension that overcomes some of the scalability issues of state machines, has been around since the 1980s. I cannot confirm or deny that it was developed to make Big Brother's telescreens work properly. State machines are in wide use to manage complexity in embedded systems, but we can now easily use them to manage complexity in our web UIs, thanks in large part to the XState library created by David Khorshid. If the state machine or state chart concept is new to you, I suggest taking a moment to get to know them by visiting statecharts.github.io before proceeding with this video. This series is not a tutorial on XState or state charts in general. Instead, I want to walk you through a common UI development scenario in which complexity creeps up on you. We'll take some simple requirements and implement them without state machines and see how complexity creeps in. We will then re-implement our UI using state charts to show how it allows us to manage that complexity in a more explicit manner. After that, we'll briefly explore some side benefits that using state charts, and XState in particular, gives us. All of the code used in this video is available on CodeSandbox and GitLab. Links are in the description. Okay, so we show up to a new product kickoff meeting and learn that our leadership now knows that laughter is the best medicine. As a result, they need us to create a page called Get a Laugh, where our users can click a button and see a funny comic as a result. They list out the simple requirements. The page has a button labeled Get a Laugh. Once the button is clicked, a comic is loaded and shown. If the button is clicked again, a new comic is loaded and shown. And a counter keeps track and displays the number of laughs requested during a session. Easy enough, we'll be done by lunch. An editorial note here, for the sake of brevity, I've pre-created some of the uninteresting code and we'll be lumping all of the interesting code together for continuity in the video. Okay, let's get started. Let's spin up our app with Create React App. Just going to remove some of the pre-generated stuff so we can start fresh. Copy in that uninteresting code I was talking about. And we will start here. We'll start with just making the frame of the component. I'm just using app because that's what the default React Create app generates. So let's see, we'll go top level with a class of app. And then another section or kind of our action area with our button. We'll have a sibling, put our laugh requests, and we'll go back up. Of the comic area. For our button, we'll say get laugh. Here we'll say laughs requested. Why I made that a span. Okay, let's go ahead and make the button handler. That should be enough to get started. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, it looks like that's working as expected. So the easy next step is to add in the counter. Just some React state. Then here we'll increment that. Okay. That appears to be working. Okay, so already that kind of matches our screenshot. Let's do the actual fetching of the comment. We'll pull in some fetch code. Okay, and let's do that here. Promise, so we'll just see what it looks like. Let's see, let's go ahead and catch the error. This will never happen, right? Service is 100% reliable. All right, let's just see what we have. Oh, I got the error first thing. It's terrible. Again. Okay, so when we get a good laugh, looking at the data, and we have an image here for the actual comic. So that's what we want to use to show our comic. So let's stick that in some state. We'll use that down here. What happens? Okay, well, that's bad. Hey, we got a comic. Okay. So we can see one improvement we need to make here immediately, right? It's like this should really only show up when we don't have a comic. We shouldn't see the broken image when we first load the page. So let's go ahead and fix that. We'll add another variable. Okay, then based on that variable, let's say if we have loaded the comic, we'll show the comic. If we haven't loaded the comic, show this other thing. Okay, so we get that. No broken comic link. That's good. so there's your comic. We refresh the page. We get that. So that's working. Excellent. So now, all proud of this, we show this off. Getting comics. It's like, oh, well, I clicked the button. It didn't load a comic. Why did that happen? Oh, that's because we had this error that was never supposed to happen. So we go, okay, well, we have to deal with that. So we need to show an error message. The error happens. So, okay, so we're going to need yet more state. Consistent. Okay, so we'll get an error. We'll set the error. And then down here, now we have a third condition that we want to deal with. So instead of trying to do all this in JSX, let's see if we can break that up a little bit. So let's add some more functions. We have a function that renders an error. And we'll return a nice polite error message. And the actual error. Okay, and then we'll have a function that actually renders comic. And it'll basically do this logic. So take not loaded the comic, we'll show this. Otherwise, that. And here we'll just say so let's see how that goes. Okay, there's our error. Okay, I clicked. I can see I'm getting data, but I still have my error message. Well, why is that? Well, it's because we didn't actually clear the error when we got good data. So let's do that. Let's see where that gets us. Okay, there's an error. Okay, now we're back to a good one. Back to a good one. Okay, and sometimes we notice when we click, it takes a long time for the comic to load. So we show this off, and they're like, if it's going to take that long for the comic to load, we should show some sort of loading spinner. Okay, we can do that. So we go back over here, we import our loading spinner. So we want to show it as soon as we start fetching. So let's add another variable. That's true here. Of course, if it comes back, we'll set the faults. And even if it's an error, we'll set the faults. down here, and we have to say we have two renders going on here. We'll say we'll do that here as well. Okay, there's our loading spinner. Loading spinner. Spinner. Okay, there's our big long delay. We see the loading spinner for a long time. Oh, there's my ear. Click that, get the loading spinner. Okay, that's good. Okay, so we're good with this. We roll with this. It's looking pretty good. And we noticed during this long delay, clicked a bunch of times because I was not patient. All of these images are loading in. So what can we do about that? Well, there are a couple of things we could do here, right? We could disable the button so that you can't click it. We could abort any in-flight requests and then send a new request, or we could just take the easy route and say, if we're loading, just don't do this. Okay. Let's see if that works. Okay, that works. I clicked that a bunch of times. The request stayed at 4. We pretty much now have the app where we want it. It's what the leadership envisioned, and it's working. We see the complexity has crept into our simple application, but for good reason. We need to provide a good user experience, and everything that we've added has improved that. The issue is that our application already has states. It's just implicit state, and we're managing it with a loose set of individual variables. We've already seen during development that doing this works, but it's easy to get subtle bugs because these interdependent variables allow for states that should not exist. If we were to add more functionality to this application, we would probably be adding more state variables, all of which would need to be set properly with any action that we take. It's going to be hard to maintain. In the next video, we'll re-implement this application using state charts. We'll see how using explicit states eliminates many of those subtle bugs and makes maintaining a complex system easier. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more, please consider subscribing to my channel.